This video will show how to perform the calibration procedure on the CX300 Cable and Antenna Analysis Option, SCAA. The CX300 ASOL Short-Open-Load Calibrator is required to perform the calibration. I will begin by opening the menu. You select the Network Analyzer selection, and there we'll choose VSWR. And that changes our current tab to show VSWR. In the lower right area, you'll see Cal. This provides access to the calibration system. To begin, we will select External Standards. Then we must establish some default settings. We'll change this mode, frequency mode, to Start-Stop. And we'll set the start frequency to be 9 kilohertz. And we'll set the stop frequency to the maximum range of the instrument that you have. This particular instrument operates to 6 gigahertz. The default CX300 operates to 3 gigahertz. Now I change the data points to 1,000 data points. And currently, this is the only Cal kit that's available. So that's the default, which is the one that we provide. Everything else can be left as it is. And we close this menu, then we simply start the calibration. To begin with, connect and open to the RF output port. After connecting the open, simply press OK. This is actually what it should look like. So now we'll hit continue. And we're prompted to now connect the short side of the calibrator to the RF output port. I've connected the short, so I will press OK. And this looks like a good response as well. So now we'll hit continue. And we'll connect the load to the RF output port. I have connected the load, so now I'll press OK. The calibration is now complete. And since I've swept this for the full band, 9 kilohertz to 6 gigahertz, I can save this as the default calibration. This would be the same as the factory calibration. I'm also going to save this as a measured calibration. The measured calibration can be done in a smaller band of interest, say 9 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz, or a specific band. So you can have two calibrations stored at the same time. I can exit the cal now. And the instrument is now calibrated. To check that, I will change my mode to return loss. I'll set the number of points to 460. And I'll change my frequency from 100 megahertz to 1 gigahertz. And I can see the load is still connected. Showing me a good return loss reading. I'm disconnecting that load and I will connect a short. And that shows a high return loss. So all of that looks proper. And that's how you do the calibration.